Welcome to the difficult second hole on the Twigdon course, Royston, known to the regulars as the football graveyard. This churned up by football boot fairway presents loads of different hazards. Trampoline corner there, you can see, drops down onto the patio into Ladder Gully. One of the only courses in Royston to have tiered seating. Social distancing prevents the fans from turning up. The green here is literally as smooth as glass. It is glass. It's going to provide a lot of challenges to today's golfers. Regulations in effect. You can see the hole there being measured. And this is, we have three players today. This is the player number one. Their ball is within regulation. Player number two. And I think we're waiting for, here goes player number three. And Slightly under, unusual. And so I think they're going to have to go away and make some running prayers. This is that second effort at the new ball. A little bit of a tweak there from the official. And yes, we're within regulation. That's great to see. So first up, we have Amy Large, 12 years old, much more familiar with footballs. But she's learned that over the years that warm-up is key.
I'm trying to get the fingers, you know.
Actually, I think she's slightly confused. This isn't a TikTok video, Amy. I think you need to get on with it. And she's still going, please. Lunch is in 5 minutes, so we need to get this done. And she steps up, like, four finger, lots of power there, lots of power. Still just learning her. And yes, clearly too confident. Typical of someone of this age range. So she's going to have another go. And let's see what happens here. So again, similar routine warm up. Djokovic like in focus, and she's, I think, I don't know what she's doing, but here we go. That's one, that's two, and that's three. And I think actually, was the ball still moving before the, she's celebrating like it's all okay, but I would like to see a replay of that, one of those shots. I think it's the third shot where I think the ball may, here we go, super slow motion. Excellent use of technology here. Excellent. And that's the first shot. Ball rocking around as a non-uniform, but no bite. No bite in the surface. Very interesting. Second shot. Forefinger armed and flicks out. That's beautiful. Beautiful technique. Now, does it stop moving? Does it stop? Yes. Yes, I believe it does. It's almost a few frames, but she gets it over the lip. Now, that lip there in the hole will pose problems. And there's Jack now. What's he doing? Yeah, he's just walked up and just leathered it. But look, he's stuck behind a hazard. Not too many cameras normally you'd find on a golf course, but, and that was over the hole as well. That lip is causing so many problems. Another little flip there. This is the fifth shot, I believe. He's bound to give up. Yeah, he's more happy to fire it straight into the cameraman's 20th hole. We did see clearly that it went over the hole. What about this one? Oh, it's just that lip again. I mean, if it wasn't there, I think there's every chance that would have gone down. What I'm hearing is the judges want to assess, was there any intent to injure the cameraman? Maybe we'll find that out. Angled technique, straightening the wrist, but not enough. Perpendicular to the tape, the green, sorry, before it's fired, and that's what leads to problems. It's typical of children of this age who haven't played before. And what's that? Very, although the wrist is firmly planted, and it's hit the lip again. Would you believe it? So now we're about to review this controversial, I think, fifth shot. And for me, it's all about the eyes. What are the eyes looking at when they flick the ball? Are they intent on getting it in the hole or hitting the cameraman? Let's have a look. This looks okay at the moment. And oh no, that's clear intent. Surely the judges are going to come down heavily on that. Yes, he thinks it's hilarious. But he's been given another go. And it's a hole in one. It's a hole in one. Would you believe it? He's off. I'm hearing the judges do want to see it again. They think there may have been tape measure assistance, but he doesn't care. He's celebrating like there's no tomorrow. That's it. Bundle your sister. Look at his face. Anyway, let's have a look at this replay. Here we go. Can we see from this angle? It's difficult to tell. It is difficult to tell. I think we need some technology here. We need Snicko. Yes! Clear peak as it hits the tape measure. Such a shame. Great shot, but illegal. Solange Senior steps up now, fresh from last week's performance. That is a big note, actually. His mum's one. Anyway, he's standard practice. Warm up, look, warm up. And oh my God, was that his hand doing that? Some sort of force? Or was it just the wind? Let's have a look. Takes his time. Oh my good God, I've never seen anything quite like that. Let's see that again in slow motion. Ball trickles towards that dodgy lip and then seems to take on a mind of its own as it rotates around the edge of the hole. Unbelievable. I've only commentated on this sort of stuff for at least 5 minutes and I've never seen anything like that before. Surely that's dented his confidence. I know he's going to recover from that. And I'm right. Too short. But the third shot goes in. I'm sure he's disappointed with that. I'm sure, yes, he is. He's kicked the ball away. I think the authorities will clamp down on this. It's bringing the game into disrepute. But actually, to pause for a moment and look at the grace with which the ball is kicked there using what looks like Adidas 17.3 Predator AstroTurf boots. It's actually textbook.